transport is absolutely key to this, isn't it? So in terms of the future direction, alongside this, there are other changes that are also happening. So the GPs have become joined together into primary care networks, and from April next year, currently the extended hours, the appointments that we are commissioning locally, that there will be additional appointments from the national scheme. So, and that will be for a range of clinicians as well. It won't just be a GP, because it's not always a GP you want to see, is it? So there's physician associates, which my clinical colleagues can explain what they are, that they will be available as well next year. So we will have more. I think the transport issue at the moment, if people can't get enough access locally, or if they're ill, then they travel already, don't they, to Arrow Park. And what we need to make sure is, and it goes back to my other point, if that's, because sometimes urgent care is because you can't access planned care in terms of, you know, if you have been reviewed and you need to see a consultant or a specialist doctor and you can't get there, then that's a bit of a disadvantage, isn't it? So transport is the issue.
I'm very grateful for our members of the public who have come today to listen and to hear the discussion. But for those who are answering questions here around the table, our councillors and our members of governing body, I would request that our public could show them some courtesy and allow them to answer the questions without hearing the mumble of conversation. So we took that through quite a rigorous process, analysing all of the data that we have. Sometimes we have an overabundance of data, but actually in this case it was really crucial that we looked at the statistics around the attendance of the ED, how it would impact on ED, but not only that, the attendances within our community, which is why I would be able to give you assurances, Councillor Usher, on that provision within the board of the Birkenhead area. And so there was clinical input in answer to your question, and there was clinical input from all of our providers, as well as the clinical input from the CCG, our GP federations, and the local medical committee as well. Sylvia, did you want to?
Yes, not a question, just a few comments really, as the lay member for patients and public engagement. First of all, I think it is important to recognise that when you reduce anything anywhere at any time, it has a negative concept, but the whole thing needs to be seen in the round. I would like to commend the CCG senior teams and comms team who did what I think was a really excellent consultation over a long period of time. And I also think it's important to note how many people did respond, and that's because people feel passionately about the local NHS and the national NHS. And I think it's fantastic that people did respond, because after all, indifference is the enemy of democracy. The option that is being put forward, and I have read a lot about it over the past 12 months, so I think I've got a reasonable grasp of the detail. It is based on data, and it's on data of the services used by different sections of the population in different parts of the Wirral. And I think Nesta has articulated this extremely well. I'm also aware, building on what you've just said, Paula, that the clinical input has been quite huge, I would think. And I think it's so important that for these sorts of services, we need to rely on clinicians, because they are the people at the forefront dealing with unhappy residents when they haven't got the service that they want, when they want it, and where they want it. My next point would be in about the areas where we are losing some hours and some opportunity to just go around the corner for a walk-in service. Again, Nesta has articulated it's not just increased other parts of the service in those areas, but as I understand it, there's going to be improvements, for example, in 111, which is obviously commissioned nationally, but it is going to be extended, improved, and a better service, and we are going to have more local GP appointments in those areas. And from the data that we look at, we know that a lot of people who go into walk-ins, or indeed to A&E at Arrow Park, it's because they can't get a GP appointment in the first place. The other point I'd just like to pull out of it is that in all of this discussion, we do keep losing track of opening an urgent treatment centre at Arrow Park that will be open 24 hours a day, is a huge improvement to the service for all rural residents. And hopefully, the data will support this, it will reduce some of the pressure on accident and emergency services. And you know, it is in the name accident and emergency, when actually what patients want, what residents want, very often is treatment. It might not be an accident or an emergency, but to that patient on that day, to them it's urgent and it's important, and they want to see a doctor or another appropriate qualified member of the NHS. My last point was, overall, this therefore is going to be an enhanced service. There is more options and more hours to access services, maybe not exactly where it is at the moment, but I'm seeing it as a net gain. I quite
two comments that Sylvia's made, one line very well, far better than I can make it, but it was just regarding the Usher Treatment Centre, and the fact that this does give the residents of Wirral, the whole of Wirral, an enhanced offer, and it is consistent, and the population will know where to go, and it will be open 24 hours a day. That will also reduce the pressure on A&E, and as we know, the pressure on A&E is huge, and that should therefore improve the outcomes for the population of Wirral. Through management of the more appropriate services that are being put into the right place. The second comment really is that as a GP at New Ferry, I'm well aware of the poverty and the problems the population there face. So anything that could reduce health outcomes to that population is obviously something you have to look at quite closely. Therefore, finding reassuring that the population, there are more GP appointments which outweigh the reduction in walk-in centre appointments, leading to, I would expect, better outcomes for the population of New Ferry, Old Ferry and Tranmere. As well as just increasing appointments, they are seeing as CGPs rather than necessarily nurses who usually sat for services. And the GPs will have full access to their healthcare records because in walk-in centres, the access that they have to records is quite limited, and therefore this should lead to better outcomes for patients and the population. Transport is clearly a concern. You would expect the patient to be the closer or certainly easier access to their GP's practices than the walk-in centre, which, whilst our local community, may still be somewhere away from where the patient lives.
Thank you. I don't want to repeat what's already been said, but it may be inevitable. In my consideration of the proposals, I would look to see whether or not, in my judgment, what's been put forward addresses the key concerns that we currently have. And they are described in some detail in the papers. And those that I've drawn out and looked at for solutions are the pressure on the A&E department, Arrow Park, and the impact that has on waiting times throughout the system. The need to aspire to improve the excellence of the clinical quality of the services that we provide. The need to address the confusing array of services that's currently provided, which has been described at some length today. Supporting the principle of providing local care, and I think very importantly, making the best use of the existing resources, particularly staff. And if I've heard correctly and read correctly, both the papers and what I've heard today, then there is an overall significant increase in the volume of service to be provided, and the Usher Treatment Centre is the obvious area, but I don't think we should overlook the fact that the significant investment in extra
imagine the situation at night time, for example. There will be anything which is there at the moment. This is approved at the urgent treatment centre. And there's the out of bounds QP. And there's three options for the patient to seek help at that time. Would there be a risk when we're looking at this again that there's a concern that there's a triple option, that we're all being funded to run at the same time and therefore we'll get reduced aid provision perhaps or something like that? That is something that I've reminded that I'd be concerned about down the line.
I'm happy to answer that,
Dr.
Ayers. I think initially, with implementation, there will be some overlap in service provision. We will always need an ED, an accident and emergency department. We will always need a secondary care hospital here in the Rural with an ED. But what we need to ensure is that the most appropriate patients who need emergency care, as Cillr said, are seen in the emergency room. And so that the urgent treatment centre will see those patients who may not have the acuity of those who are seen within the emergency room. In that way, we will have patients with lower acuity seen in the urgent treatment centre, and those who absolutely need accident and emergency are seen in the ED. And that in itself will improve the our target in terms of the swift management of patients, helping them flow through the department and onto ward if required. But it will help with that flow through the hospital, whilst in tandem, those with lesser clinical needs be seen within the urgent treatment centre. At that point, we will need to then review the out of hours provision and what requirements that we have. But it would be wrong to start to preempt that at this point. And I think what we need to do is establish where we want to get to in terms of our ED, urgent treatment centre, and then review the out of hours provision as well. But ultimately, and the main aim is the delivery of high quality urgent health and care to our population here in Wirral. So, on that note, I want to thank everybody around the table for their input today. But more so, something that I've said before and that's been said here today is to thank you, our public, who demonstrated such great will and determination throughout the consultation in terms of your responses, the petitions, etc. While some say may see that as conflict, I actually see that as a very good thing. I think it's really important that we take on board the and recognise the input that you have had into the services that are delivered within your area. I think it shows the depth of feeling around those services. And I hope that our recommendations to the board here today demonstrate a responsive nature of the CCG. The reason we went out to an external body in the Hitch report was to ensure transparency and to ensure that the responses from our population were reviewed in a very open and transparent way and that they weren't given a CCG flavour to it. I also want to reassure our colleagues around the table that whatever services are